We all need to get stuff done, but we don't always want to do it. We know that it's probably good for us to do the work, but something stops us from taking action. To some people, that's a sign that our minds need a break. But for those who want to learn more, do more, and be more, there comes a point where you have to figure out how to be more productive. Productivity has been a big craze over the last few years. It's like everyone is competing to see how they can outwork each other by just shaving 5 minutes off their day. It's very easy to feel like people are starting to impose their productivity practices on other people in toxic ways and maybe even making them feel inadequate for lagging behind. So let me start by saying this. Being productive should not come at the expense of your mental health, your much needed downtime, or your relationships. It's actually supposed to be the opposite, and anyone who tells you otherwise is just actually giving you bad advice. But that being out of the way, I personally think the notion of being productive is great. After all, we all have a limited amount of time on this earth, and so obviously a lot of us are gonna wanna experience the most out of every single second of our day. Like if you could do a 1 hour task in 10 minutes and do it to the same quality, why wouldn't you do that? Now obviously there's exceptions to that, like watching a film or spending time with your family and friends, but for the most part, having some tricks up your sleeve to help you get things done is something I recommend to everyone. And whether or not we want to, most of us have work to do. We do it to put food on the table, to progress up the career ladder, or simply because we enjoy getting better at what we do. There's times where we have a lot of external pressure on us to be productive, like submitting work on a deadline in order to get paid. But for creative work or the side hustles that you work on in your spare time, no one's really there to make sure you get that work done. If the only one who cares about getting the job done is us, then how do we find it in ourselves to do the work? How do we know when to pick up the pace instead of falling into a downward spiral? How do we stay productive? Having self-discipline wasn't really in my nature growing up. I had a short attention span. My focus would jump from one thing to the next and the smallest distractions could take my eyes off the bigger picture. So I started to ask myself three questions. Number one, what's important to me? What is it exactly that I want to do more of? Number two, how do I create more time to do those important things? And number three, how do I get those things done when I don't particularly feel like it? Now, some of my answers to these are constantly evolving, and others, it might take me a lifetime to figure out to the best of my ability. But what I can share with you are my favorite tips from several years of trial and error and standing on the shoulders of giants. I've read countless self-help books, listened to some of the world's best thought leaders, and implemented their advice until I found a comfortable mix of things that work well for me. So here's how I stay productive and focused. Number one, do what matters. The best way to figure out what's important to you is to take a simple mental exercise. It involves you writing down all the activities that you value in life, like family, travel, learning, creating, and then tallying up activities that pair up with them. For example, when I took the exercise, YouTube came up pretty high on the list because it gives me a creative outlet, it can be monetized in many different ways, and it gives me the opportunity to meet new people and even teach others. If I can do it as a full-time doctor, I'm sure you can make time for something you want to get started on, even if it just requires half an hour a day. I'd also recommend thinking about the Pareto principle or the 80-20 rule to help you. It's the idea that 80% of your results come from 20% of your work. Now, the 80-20 rule applies to a lot of other situations, but in this context, I use it to think about what are the most important tasks that I should be focusing on. It also involves sacrificing the not so important things, which brings me on to tip number two. You can't create time for something, you make room. Whatever your starting point, you're already doing something for every hour of the day. That's a given. It could even be you sitting on your bed doing nothing, but that's still something. Now, if you want to prioritize something, you need to start saying no to some of the things you're already doing and also to the new things that are constantly fighting for your attention. For example, if you start saying no to the 3-hour gaming session you have every single night, you've now replaced that 3 hours in your day for something else. More importantly, when new tasks or projects come your way, say no to anything that doesn't help you get the important stuff done. I mean, you have to be a little bit selfish if you want to achieve your own goals. For so long, I was willing to help other people with their goals, but I never prioritized mine. And I was so preoccupied with doing that that I never had time to think about what my priorities were. By constantly doing things, I automatically thought I was being productive, but really, I was confusing movement for action. There's a great line in the book Anything You Want by Derek Sivers where he says, if you're not feeling, hell yeah, that would be awesome about something, say no. So start fresh by saying no to everything. Then make conscious decisions about what you'll say yes to. Number three, make things easy for yourself. How do you do what's important when you don't feel like it? Firstly, there are plenty of ways to create good habits and systems in order to get work done. And funnily enough, the majority of the best ones all happen to be mentioned in just one book, Atomic Habits. The author, James Clear, explains numerous techniques to help us make our habits more obvious, easy, and rewarding. He states that you should try and make the good habits obvious and the bad habits hidden. For example, if you want to eat more apples, then put them where you can always see them. He also gives a great trick for making the boring habits more exciting. If you're finding it difficult to write, but you know you need to get it done, you can reward yourself with a coffee or snack each time you get a certain amount of words done. You think you'd be smart enough not to be trained in that way, but apparently you can positively reinforce behaviors in that way, just like you trained a dog. I've also found several other techniques that work for me, like building systems to make common tasks easy and repeatable, or creating a social contract with my followers where I say that I'm gonna get something done in order to add the extra pressure when I need it most. There are so many brilliant books, articles, and free TED Talks out there that can help you develop some internal motivation and discipline. There really isn't an excuse anymore to say that we don't have access to them. But you see, there's another side to productivity that most people don't talk about, and it's arguably the most important part. We all strive to be productive for two main reasons. The first is simply to do things more quickly and save time. And the second is so that we can make time for what we really want to do. If you're so busy doing the things that you don't want to do, but you can't find the time to do the things that you actually want to do, then you might call yourself productive, but I'd call it being overworked. So make room for the things that relax you, that help you switch off and give you the time to re-energize for another day. Not only will it help you in the long run with being more productive, but it'll also increase your quality of life. I mean, why work for 10 years straight so that you can eventually spend time with your friends and family when you could be doing that right now, through a portion of your day, every day? If you enjoy watching movies, watch them. Build it into your routine so that you get to do what you like and maybe even use it as a reward after a long day of work. Doing nothing but work in order to be celebrated by others isn't a form of productivity. It's a form of self-punishment. So I'm being more lenient with myself and forgiving about letting myself rest. Because surely it can't be normal to be switched on all day and night. The problem with being self-employed or having creative side hustles is that any time is potential work time. Soon you find yourself doing work all day and there's no clear boundary for when you should stop. So cement your breaks into your routine. Make them as important as the work itself, and I promise you that your mind and body will thank you for it. And that's pretty much all I wanted to say for now. If you've got some original or unorthodox productivity tricks up your sleeve, then I'd love to hear them, so please share it with us in the comments below. Thank you if you've watched this far, and please remember to like the video because it really does help creators like me to grow. You can follow me on Instagram and also sign up to my mailing list where I send out weekly articles. Or if you'd like, I recently made two videos about how I needed a social media detox and then how that detox actually went down, so you can check those out if you haven't already. Links will all be in the description. Otherwise, see you next week. Bye.